In the name of God Almighty, the Most Gracious, the Most Merciful, Your Highness Sheikh Mohammed Rashid Al Maktoum, Vice President, Prime Minister, and Ruler of Dubai, Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests. I'm happy to be with you here for the second consecutive year, and I'm happy as well to be amongst an elite of our students in the institutions and the universities. His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid has launched an initiative to turn into smart services and turn all governmental services into mobile services. 393 services were part of the Ministry of Interior. As part of these services, we wanted to share our services with the society, and this is what His Highness has always told us. A part of these social services have become part of the society. 23 services have been given to the universities and the educational institutions alike. 16 service where the committee given the responsibility to take care of these services have taken charge of these services, 16 services, and therefore we as for me, in person, I think that they all rank the first I shall mention the universities where the students have been part. We have the technical faculty in Dubai. We have Sheikh Khalifa University and other technical faculties at Al Ain and the police faculties. The committee, given the responsibility of choosing these applications, was a neutral committee working outside of the umbrella of the Ministry of Interior, but the director of the faculty wanted to have the students participate in this contest. This means a lot, Your Highness. This means that we have faculties and institutions and universities that use these services that students have offered. They have offered them, not the private companies. They are competing with the services rendered by big consulting companies. I would like to thank as well my sister's students from the Al Ain Technical School, because the service that they have offered for the impaired and the disabled was important. Thank you. I wish you all the success. Thank you all. May God bless you. Today, Your Highness, we are talking about governmental services and turning them into smart and electronic services on the phone. As you see, ladies and gentlemen, your predecessors, the Emiratis, were in the forefront to provide this service and to relay it in the best means possible. I've noticed that this child is not more than 3 or 4 years of age. She rides on a camel and she is drinking water. This picture means to me that in the past, perhaps this picture comes from the 50s, To move from one place to another was a challenge. Why? Because there is scarcity in food, in water, and danger from crossing the roads. And therefore, if we move with our families from point A to point B, we need to go early in the morning, to leave early in the morning, to have limited food and limited water. And therefore, this family or this household did not have time to stop over so that this child drinks water or rests or eats some food. And therefore, they have created a means to provide the needs of this child in a very prompt manner so that they will not be delayed and at the same time give the child the food and the water that she needs. The government of the UAE, headed by His Highness Sheikh Khalifa, the President of the United Arab Emirates, is taking care of its citizens as such. This is an exceptional work. Do you want to be an exceptional leader? Thank you. I will not be speaking further about the electronic services because you have experts who will be speaking about this in a detailed and more accurate manner, and therefore I will be speaking about the qualities and characteristics of an exceptional leader. In the past, we used to when they used to say that this person is creative, has an unlimited knowledge, and therefore we have the director, he is promoted to a director and then to a leader. But in the results that we are seeing in the UAE and in some of the other countries and some of the companies and institutions, no wonder that these are exceptional things. Let us know, what are these exceptional characteristics that produce exceptional work, or who is the exceptional leader? Let us see the circumstances all over the world from 2008 to date. What has happened all over the world? The world has passed through economic crises, political crises, health crises, security crises. The volume of the employment that have been lost from 2008 until 2013, 31 million jobs. In Europe, 43 million people do not find enough food to sustain themselves, according to the Red Cross. 120 million people are on the verge of poverty in the 2013. Let's see what happened to the United Arab Emirates. We had a clear strategy. We launched three satellites, Satyasat, and so on and so forth. We had Formula One, we had Irina, we had Expo 2020. And also, we held the government summit 2012 in the midst of this crisis. I shall give you an example. The governments usually market themselves before practicing its job and gives an agenda that it will do this and that, and then after it reaches the government, you know what's the result. The UAE has imposed the government of His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid on its employees this challenge to put all the indicators between the citizens of the UAE. We shall not talk in details about everything which has occurred in the UAE, but we will be talking about some of these characteristics. The concept of happiness, ladies and gentlemen, was present since the beginning of the Federation. And before also the Federation, the establishment of the Federation, when each of the Emirates had individual challenges, every one of our leaders were working on establishing happiness and achieving happiness. After the creation of the Federation, the work was more comprehensive and the challenge was bigger. But one of the objectives of our founders is to achieve happiness to the citizens of our beloved nation. We exerted all efforts needed. This happiness does not achieve just like that, but it needs perseverance, it needs work, efforts, and coordination, and to measure the performance. Happiness, according to the evaluation from the Columbia University in the United States of America, in the Arab world, we rank the first place as happiness, as citizens, and as a nation. Worldwide, number 14, Your Highness Sheikh Khalifa and Sheikh Mohammed want to break this number, and therefore we are talking about this today at the government summit. The economic crisis. Today, ladies and gentlemen, despite all the economic crisis, we had an economic crisis, definitely, but the foreign investments have increased 40%. The rate of travelers in our airports has increased 113%. I cannot forget the decision taken by the UAE to increase buying airplanes, whether in the Emirates airline or Etihad Airlines. And I think that this is a very bold step where all worldwide companies are really losing money due to their buying airplanes. Despite everything, and due to this vision, not every leader can see this. An exceptional leader can see this, and not a normal leader. We bought these airplanes. This needs a cycle of services. It needs an organization. which is happiness. Perhaps one of the most important things in this framework is the security aspect. The lack of the absence of organized crime in the UAE in the 2013, it was number 32 worldwide. Now we rank first in the year 2013, according to the Davos Economic Forum. We rank first in the year 2013 when it comes to the absence of organized crime, and we would like to welcome the president of the Economic Forum in the UAE. Your Highness, I'm present with your brothers and sisters in the Ministry of Interior. I attend some of the meetings with them, and we are always keen to have these services rendered to the citizens, to have these services measured in a foreign manner so that we know where we rank worldwide and where we are at the moment and how we can develop and to see the satisfaction rate of the employees. What I saw was one of the indicators, the general or public satisfaction rate and complete satisfaction rate. The leadership in the UAE is looking for public satisfaction. It is looking definitely for complete satisfaction, and this is one of the measurements that the government in the future will be measuring according to all the ministries alike. There's a saying which says that the satisfaction of the people is of vital importance. But in the UAE, under the umbrella of His Highness Sheikh Khalifa and Sheikh Mohammed Rashid Al Maktoum, we are trying to break this rule. We say that the satisfaction of the people is a conscious objective. Definitely, the exceptional leader draws and creates the future. What does this mean? At one time, we've been seeing paintings for painters. They paint this fountain and this beautiful picturesque view. When you ask, where is this from? They tell you this is from the imagination of the painter. The exceptional leader sees the future in a similar way. We are learning today the vision, but Sheikh Zayed had this vision 50 years ago. He was able to achieve it. How? The late Sheikh Zayed went to United Kingdom in the 50s, and he was with a number of colleagues, and he spoke that he said, indeed, that you will see that the UAE will be having very soon roads, hospitals, markets, infrastructure, and so on and so forth. So a number of those who were near him at the time, they weren't serious, and they thought that he wasn't serious, perhaps not soon, but at a later stage. He used to ask them, how much does it take you if you want to go to Fujairah from Fujairah to Salah? Perhaps it might take us 3 days or 5 days. Soon, he said, you will be able to leave and come back in the same day. No doubt that this leader who used to see what others couldn't see and couldn't expect that it can be achieved. This is an exceptional leader. He sees the picture, the big picture, and tries to implement it on the ground.
كذلك اليوم لما
Today, when His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid was insisting that the government should turn into an electronic government because he sees the future. He sees the future that the governmental services, electronic governmental services, is the future, and they will be facilitating for the government and for the citizens, whether nationals or expats, their work, and this will be in the interest of the government and the citizens alike.
السمات الأخرى الإصرار والعزيمة.
Determination. What about determination to be an exceptional leader? You should have this determination because you believe in this picture that you need to achieve.
40 سنة.
40 years, ladies and gentlemen, to establish a nation from a desert. No doubt that this is an exceptional work, and we have exceptional leaders. We have spoken last year of the troubles of the society in the past. They had no mobile phones, they had no roads, no nothing, but they were determined to reach a result. Construction and development. Constant development. In the year 2008, companies lost millions of jobs. The UAE government has insisted on development, on construction. What were the results today? The prices of the shares and the real estate in the UAE now are the highest than the number that we have reached at that time when the crisis occurred in the year 2008. Now the prices of the real estate are higher than at the time. Due to this vision, we achieved these results today. To have this determination to win Expo 2020 in the UAE, I would like to mention something in person. The market was awaiting Expo 2020. If the UAE wins Expo 2020, the market of the shares and the real estate will rise. And if the UAE loses Expo 2020, the market the market prices will decrease. Before Expo 2020, 2 days before the event, Sheikh Mohammed held a statement. He says that if we win Expo 2020, this is what we want and we desire, and if not, we shall create Expo 2020. So the determination to achieve success is one of the characteristics of an exceptional leader. Clarity and accuracy is also one of the characteristics of an exceptional leader. Sheikh Zayed, the late Sheikh Zayed, has founded a nation and said that this nation should be based on certain pillars, principal pillars and main pillars. It should be a strong federal country. It should have an army, a strong army of the armed forces, very strong economy, and it should really enjoy justice in dealing with the individuals of the society.
مثال على
Let me give you an example of accuracy and clarity. Sheikh Zayed, the late Sheikh Zayed, had people over and he loved falcons. You know how he loved falcons. He said that if a person has a falcon, don't give him food in the evening, but wait until the morning so that we might take him elsewhere. So therefore, if the falcon wants to hunt, he will hunt for himself and not for you. The late Sheikh Zayed told this person, you did not understand what I told you. The exceptional leader does not like the word of clarity without any meaning. I told you something. When I tell you something, you should really relay it in a clear way. And if not, you should understand it. And this applies on the clarity of the agenda of His Highness Sheikh Khalifa bin Zayed, the President of the UAE, ascertained by His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid Al Maktoum, clarity and accuracy, a system of evaluation and performance, a clear system of evaluation and performance. The message was clear, published in the media outlets, in the formal publications. The UAE in the next 7 years will be the first worldwide in security, in infrastructure, the easiness of carrying out our work, and the responsiveness to calls in 4 minutes only. There is no accuracy and clarity in a government all over the world in this sense and in this transparent manner. So accuracy and clarity is one of the characteristics of an exceptional leader.
حنون كالأب ومشارك كالقائد في نفس الوقت. سواء كان عن طريق المشاركة الاجتماعية أو المشاركة في اتخاذ القرار.
And this is through participation in decision making.
الإمارات نموذج.
The United Arab Emirates
متفرد في الحقيقة.
Is a unique model at many levels.
نجد.
It is exceptional because His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid,
سيدي سمو الشيخ محمد بن زايد,
His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed,
عندهم مجالس أسبوعية,
have their own majlis or their own council
مع المواطن,
where they can sit and meet with the citizens. What does this mean? This means that they have this appointment with the citizens where they can discuss the services provided by the government. And here we can say that their highnesses are the eyes of the citizens and the government. Today, most of our leaders have their own accounts in social media. The media. When we have these live broadcasting channels, there is no doubt that the citizen would be able to express his opinion to the public. And this is an example of public participation.
دائما في ذهني شيخ محمد بن راشد.
His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid says,
للاحتياج لتلبية احتياجات.
Whenever we seek to satisfy the needs of the people, we see that the presidents of the state is at the forefront of these efforts. What does this mean? This means that the leader and the vice president have the same objective. If they think about a certain purpose, they see that the other leader has been at the forefront of these efforts.
جولة سيدي سمو الشيخ محمد بن زايد في الإمارات الشمالية.
The tour of His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed of the Northern Emirates.
هي كذلك.
Following the request of His Highness Sheikh Khalifa, this tour aimed at assessing the needs of the citizens and at listening to their requirements.
المجلس. نتج عنها شو؟
What was the outcome of this visit? The outcome of this visit was that
وزارة شؤون الرئاسة
the president of the UAE informed the
رئيس الدولة
the department responsible for the presidency affairs to respond to the requests of the citizens. Here, I would like to thank His Highness Sheikh Mansour for his initiative. Instilling loyalty and love. If you are an exceptional leader, you should be capable of instilling loyalty in the hearts of the people. Late Sheikh Zayed was known for loving plants, flora, water, and the palms.
And
he used to take the example of planting, of instilling. He used to love giving examples. He used to respect the people and lead by example. He used to plant trees, and I remember that the TV channels used to cover this. Planting or sowing is a very important concept. What does it mean? It means that you are responsible for taking care of the plant that you have planted. And if you're not capable of doing that, your son or your daughter should do it. So this is an important link that enhances relationships between the different members of the same family. So this plant would enhance and create love within the same family, instilling and sowing loyalty. When we faced a problem in the UAE, UAE citizens said that the UAE comes first and President Khalifa comes first.
حتى تكسب قلوب العالم.
In order to gain the hearts of the people
وعقولهم
لابد and to win their minds, you should be honest. So honesty is another characteristic of an exceptional leader. And one of the basic principles of leadership is based on the following proverb, say always yes and do whatever you want. So as we know, you cannot achieve or make an achievement through lying. Lies are not sustainable, and an exceptional leadership is a sustainable leader, is a leader who governs for a long time. This is why lying is not an a characteristic of an exceptional leader. Being or leading by example. This is also another basic characteristic of an exceptional leader. I am about to conclude, just bear with me. The message of late Sheikh Zayed to Sheikh Khalifa was clear. In 1973, the Egyptian Arab Republic was under attack. Late Sheikh Zayed, may God rest his soul, sent his big son to the front. Or his eldest son to the front, to assess the needs of the Egyptian people. And undoubtedly, this is how a leader should be prepared. Late Sheikh Zayed was preparing Sheikh Khalifa to become a leader. In 1973, a crown prince was sent to the front in Egypt. What does this mean? This means that Egypt is very dear to the heart of late Sheikh Zayed. Egypt is dear to the heart of His Highness Sheikh Khalifa and His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid and His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed. Egypt is dear to the hearts of all of us. In 1973, the United Arab Emirates stood by the Egyptian people against one enemy, who is Israel at that time. The enemy of Egypt is the enemy of the UAE, and the enemy of the Egyptian people is the enemy of the Emirati people. Today, we are discussing exceptional leadership. His Highness, the President, at that time sent his eldest son to the front. His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid and His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed. Here, I would like to extend my heartfelt thanks to our armed forces, who are one of the main institutions in the UAE. Their representation of the UAE in Kosovo, Afghanistan, and other countries, or their presence in Kosovo and Afghanistan, seek to ensure security and provide humanitarian services. We are very proud of this mission.
صناعة القادة سيدي اسمه شيخ محمد بن زايد وسيدي اسمه الشيخ محمد
His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid
هذه المسارح شو يعني
Are leaders What does this mean
هو
This means
يقف على العمل على المنفذ على على الميدان
Their Highnesses are monitoring
يقول للباقي
What's happening on the ground
العمل في المكتب
and
بدون ما يكون عندك نظر للواقع لمسرحة المسرح العمليات أو
insist
لا يمكنك
having a vision that allows you to be an exceptional leader so if you want to be an exceptional leader you should be the one who directly monitors what's happening on the ground I have a question to the public. After all what we have seen, do you think that our leaders are exceptional?
Wow, بس. مثال من مئات الأمثلة ولكن هذا
This is an example among 100 other examples.
سيدي اسمه الشيخ خليفة.
His Highness.
يستجيب
لمواطن. شيخ خليفة.
وصل خبر على أن الخدمات.
Is informed that a certain citizen has complained that the ambulance services do not arrive on time in certain areas. He called me personally and he told me that the service in this area isn't satisfying the needs of the citizens. And he asked me to measure the level of efficiency. And after investigation, we have found that the citizen was right. Therefore, His Highness Sheikh Khalifa has allocated a budget to improve this service and he said that this service should be delivered on time and according to international standards. 20 additional points were allocated to this service according to the international standard and two other helicopters. Here we can see the green areas, the green points where the additional services will be provided. If you have any remarks, or comments about this service, you are welcome to convey it to the Ministry of Interior. I hope that you wouldn't need to do that, but I would like to tell you that on the website of the Ministry of Interior, you can share your opinion about the performance of this sector or other sectors under the Ministry of Interior.
شيخ خليفة وجه.
His Highness Sheikh Khalifa.
وبعدين سيدي اسمه الشيخ.
Guided and His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid said, "Where do you train UAE nationals?" They said, "We train them here in the UAE, and we have experts from other countries."
فكذلك في هذا الشيء الإضافي. فتم التعاقد مع جامعة هارفارد.
His Highness decided to sign a contract with Harvard University in order to establish a new academy.
الخدمة الدورة إن شاء الله راح تنتهي بيدخلون إن شاء الله في.
And the training course will be completed by the end of this year.
خلال سنتين إن شاء الله راح تكون.
Within 2 years.
الوحدات الإسعاف والإنقاذ. من أبنائكم وبناتكم
All of the ambulance and the medical staff will be trained and according to international standards.
Yeah. سؤال كذلك للأخوة الحضور.
I have another question to the public.
أتقبل أن تكون أقل
درجة. Do you accept to be less exceptional than the exceptional leader?
الإجابة نريد كل واحد يحتفظ بها لنفسه.
I would like you to keep your answers for yourselves. I would like to thank those who shared their opinions with me, Sheikh Alubna and Dream.
هل تقبل أن تكون أقل استثناء؟
Do you accept to be less exceptional? The president of the UAE is an exceptional leader. The prime minister is an exceptional leader. Do you believe, ladies and gentlemen, that they would choose a minister, undersecretary, or other employees who are unexceptional? I would like to tell you and tell the others, if you are not an exceptional minister, you won't be able to survive in this government. Allow me, Your Highness, to convey a message to the three most important components of the UAE society, and this is a final message to all fathers and mothers. If you want to raise exceptional generations, you should be exceptional. You should start by being exceptional. To every teacher, you should be exceptional so that you can raise an exceptional generation. For all officials in this government at the different levels, you should also be exceptional so that your work would be exceptional. Thank you so much, Your Highness. Thanks a lot for your attention.